So, is Miro mind mapping a great way to mind map? We will be checking out the application in today's video. Before we begin, a little word from our sponsor this month, that is Zoho Suite. Hello folks, before we dive into this video, our sponsor for February 2020 is Zoho Suite. Now, Zoho Suite is a range of products covering sales to help desks to email and much more. They wanted us to focus in on one of their products, which is Zoho Projects. Now, Zoho Projects is a way for your team to manage projects and work in and out of the office. They have features like task management, time tracking, charts, reports, including Gantt chart abilities, plenty of issue tracking features for bugs, and also Zoho Analytics integrations too. With success stories from construction industries to software development, it's a popular place to bring all of your projects into one place. So thanks to Zoho Suite for sponsoring this month on Keep Productive. So guys, Miro is two sort of platforms. It's a collaborative whiteboard tool that allows you to create these fantastic areas to work on, a little bit like Miro Note, those sorts of applications. But there is a free mind mapping tool, and in today's video, we're gonna be checking that out. Let's start by giving you an overview, and then let's dive into the features, and then let's round off who this is best recommended for. So let's start off with the overview. This application is apparently used by 3 million users worldwide and a range of different teams. But there is a mind mapping experience. As I said, it's free. Said that there's no credit carding that needed, required for this application, which is pretty good. And allows you to create these sort of like massive diagrams. And maybe that's you trying to plan holistically, or you just trying to jot down a few ideas for a project that you have at work. But we're gonna check out the features of this. It is free, as I said, so you're not gonna be incurring any costs. Then later on, maybe a few weeks from now, we'll check out Miro as a collaborative whiteboard application. So here we are, folks, with Miro Mind Map. Now, just to note, what I actually did was I went over to Miro at the top left-hand corner, which basically gives you access to all of your boards. And as you can see here, you can create a blank board. In the free plan, you only get up to 3 boards, which I guess is sort of like a, you know, it's a bit weird sometimes because you think, you know, mind mapping is going to be totally free. But because they have boards inside of this, if I go to create a mind map, you can see that I only have 1 board left. So you can only have up to 3 actively created boards. So let's go and create this board anyway. Now, as you can see, they give you this sort of demo one to get things rolling. And what I'm going to do for the sake of this video is just to delete that. And all I did there was just press delete. And you can see here that if I use my 2 fingers, I can scroll around the mind map. Now, the best way to create mind maps, you can actually create them from scratch on your own, but is to go over to the left-hand panel and press templates. Now, if I go over to the mind map template, I can choose from a range of them. And you can see that there's bottom business model canvas here, the product roadmap. There's even like, for example, you can actually create your own custom templates. But you can see here there's some brainstorming and ideation ones. So if you have a specific like journey map, like with your team, maybe we'll show some of these at the end. For example, these are good with Atlassian based products. Then you can use that and user stories, customer journey, etc. But just for the sake of this video, let's use a basic mind map. Now you can even add it with a filled example so you can get going. But in this case, let's go with a blank one. So as you can see here, this is the mind map, and you can use your 2 fingers to scroll around if you've got a Mac or trackpad, and you can zoom out as well. And that's the, I believe you can sort of, that's sort of the size of the canvas, just to give you an idea. So it does give you plenty of wiggle room, especially if you went and created them quite small across your board. And the great thing is you can use a search up here to specifically find something. There's even filtering based on the threads that you follow and objects that you've snapped as well. So let's go ahead and delete this left-hand side because we're gonna go ahead and create a company map. So let's zoom in a little. So let's create a company map for Keep Productive. So what do we cover? Let's delete some of these. Now, the best way to start this is if you press Tab. Tab basically creates a new branch of your mind map. So in Keep Productive, we do YouTube. So if I press Enter, a new branch is created, which is very cool. So I can also add courses because that's something else that we do. And also, let's say articles as well. So the other thing you can do is constantly press Tab and it will just recreate a new element. So if I would say blog articles, I can enter a new element there. Now, one thing I can do is if you're part of a team, what it can do is I can go and leave a comment. There are plenty of options here and we'll come back to that in a moment, but I can leave a comment that can be dragged over the top of something. In this case, if I wanted to let Alice know, you could at mention her if you had her in and available inside the Miro workspace. But in this case, I might say, add the themes for the blog here, Alice. Many thanks. And you can even add emoji if you want there. So if I press enter, you can see that the comment appears here. And I can even add a different color to that comment and move it around as well. So she will get a notification up in the top right hand corner and it will appear in her unread earlier. And you can even see all updates here if you want to. That's really handy, actually having some sort of communication with your team as you go. But that's not where it ends. For example, you can add a whole host of abilities. For example, sticky notes. Sticky notes are a handy way for you and your team to keep updated. And for some people on their own, you may just want sticky notes to replicate what you would see on Mac, a Mac computer, or even a Windows computer, leaving little notes for yourself, things like that. But it's also handy for teams if you're looking to get, key information. For example, it could be the login email that you use, maybe not the password, but it might be information such as that. So in this case, I might say login is account. Squarespace.com, and that could be helpful for the team to have. So if I make it a little bit smaller, I can even reduce the size of the text, I believe. So there we go, it can be a little bit more in line, but you can even add little rungs off this. And if I wanted to go back to this, I can add either side, so that's really preset. But the one thing I can do is if I wanted to, I could go ahead and create a new shape. And I could make my own mind map if I was someone who was a bit more custom. So I could say, company, for example. And I could use the branches here to create a new mind map. And you can create all types of abilities. So, for example, you could weave the sticky note into there. And at any given point, you can change the elements into these variety elements. Like this one is a card. This one's a comment. And you can even make it sort of memo-like there. So that's one of the benefits of utilizing the custom builds. But what's good is if you wanted to utilize the space, for example, you wanted to add a Kanban framework, which might help you and your team to organize a certain project coming up, you can have it in the same environment as your mind map. And that's quite helpful, particularly for people who want to have lots of different things all in one area. So if I go and zoom into this, you can see that in this case, I can actually utilize this like I would a Kanban. This is more for sprints for teams, but as you can see, it works in the same fashion and I can just add a new card and find the details. So let's just test something here. So let's say in progress is this Miro review. Now, if I go up to the top right hand corner and press Miro, you can see there that the card is automatically detected and it will zoom into this particular thing. And whenever you're inside of a new card in a Kanban, you can also set a date. And that's with every single card you create inside of Miro. So in this case, I might want to say, actually, we're going to post this one Saturday. I can assign it to a person and I can even give it a tag as well. Very much like you would with pretty much Trello or any other application. But as you can imagine, it's much more visual and more basic to some extent. So what else I can do on this left-hand panel is I've already been able to add text, shapes, anything else like that. But what's cool is there's this pen feature. Now, if I were, say, someone that wanted to use it on iPad and I could write, you know, hello very neatly. This is on touchpad, so as you can imagine, it's going to be a bit messy. But what you can do is you can utilize this feature called smart drawing. So for example, if I went to do a circle, and as me being myself, the non-artist, I went to create a circle, okay, a little bit upsided, but it automatically detects that. Now, apparently this feature's available in beta, but you can do it for a range of things. Apparently you can do it with a star, but I wouldn't be very good at doing a star. There we go. So it's pretty decent in terms of being able to sort of activate anything. And if you select the cursor icon, you can also move it around. So naturally that's something that I think people will like, especially designers. You can see here that the eraser is pretty easy to use, and it will instantly delete anything away. So if I wanted to get rid of any text, I could do. So we've demonstrated the comment abilities, but let's also talk about the frame abilities. Now, if you're a designer or someone that may want to demonstrate a website or something like that, maybe mock up an iPad application or mock up a poster or, you know, get comments on something like that, then what I could do is I can add a frame. And frames basically help you to, so this is an Android phone frame. You can see there that it helps you to coordinate that project. And in this case, I could drag stuff onto it, snap it into place, and that could be quite helpful. I can also upload images as well. I can upload them from URL through the device or also through Chrome extension as well. Now, there are a few integrations. You can, for example, use sticky captures, Mindmap, Kanban. These are some of the apps that are already pre-installed, but we've already demonstrated. You can also use Icon Finder as well. So it also got an integration with Icon Finder. So if I was designing a new calendar application on the smartphone, I could obviously drag it over to here. So having some of those integrations do save you a bit of time. And you can even post iframe, web page capture, and also tables and charts. And you can add more apps, but I do believe that falls into a new pricing category. So you're probably wondering what's this down in the bottom left-hand corner. So you can also find all of the frames that you're currently working on. So for example, you can title this one something a little bit different, like Android Calendar App. And as you can see here are updates on this left-hand side. So if you had tons of them, you'd be able to find them fairly fast. Now, if I go down to here, there is this presentation mode, which makes it a little bit more interactive. You can see here that if you had a specific app that you wanted to hone in on, then it does focus in on that. But the presentation mode just basically removes any of the editing abilities. So it's almost like a locked experience so that you can just drag around. Maybe you want to put it up on a big whiteboard for you and your team to gain value from. So that's just something to note. You can also see comments as a tab here per board and whether notes has been left for you, and also chat. So that's also a handy feature if you and your team are working in real time. This application was previously called Real Time Board, I believe. So it does have the abilities that you can work as together. It's sort of like a Google Doc. You see someone else's cursor at the same time. You can also see the cards that have been added. So these are blank cards that have been added to the Kanban, and you can click in and find them pretty instantaneously as well. And you can even see app mentions inside of the cards that are specific to yourself or another team member. And here as well, you can also see the activity log. So you can see every little thing that has been done and even the state and location of those things, which is very handy if you and your team are adding lots of information. And what's nice, you can hide that away so you can come find it later. So over here, there are a few things you can do. For example, in settings, you can change whether you follow the threads, you can learn the shortcuts. We learned a few like tabbing, but there is also, for example, if I wanted to move the article section, if I press Command Shift and drag the item, I can actually move it to a completely different area. So that's Command Shift on Mac and drag. But I'll just double check on that one. So you can open up the tabbing there, and many of the features work pretty succinctly. So you can even add shapes as well. So for example, like R, O, L for arrow, etc., which is pretty handy if you're looking to save a bit of time. You can also find your account settings down here. And is this also this sort of learn and inspire like mini university feature? So if you want to work out how to do retrospectives or use a framework, so they've got a few there. You also have all updates, which I mentioned earlier. You've got the search up here. And there's this sort of like note feature where you can actually start like notes, which is quite cool. So if I started a to-do list, I can start sort of managing it here. But I'm just curious how that connects up. So if I opened it up as a full, you can see that the note is available there. But as you can imagine, it's just sort of like a pinned experience on that right-hand side. I'm guessing if you wanted to drag stuff in, it doesn't look like you can do, but maybe that's why it's beta. Maybe you would probably do that in the future. So that's quite a just a neat way to be able to just add additional notes on this left-hand panel. So let's touch on the pricing. As I explained, you do have free access to the mind maps and you can create a fair few, but you are limited to only three boards in total if you're a one-member team. And apparently, if you want to upgrade, you're going to have to be a team of five by the looks of it, because there's no way to actually upgrade past that. It's $40. And as you can see, it's that's per yearly. So it's about works out about $10 per month if you got billed monthly, but that gives you unlimited boards, projects, frameworks, and Jira and Confluence integrations, as well as Kanban framework. So that's something that you just need to note if you're looking to upgrade past those existing boards. But as you can imagine, it's something that you'll have to check out, give your own value. But I think it's a pretty neat tool overall. Let's just round up with a bit of a summary of what this application can do. So you're probably wondering, who is this most suitable for? Now, Miro mind mapping is a great way to sort of collectively bring all of your thoughts together. As I said, whether that could be for a project, whether it's for an idea, ideation, which is very popular. And many people like Ian in a part of this community, he uses MindNode, which is a great application. And you've also got applications like MindMeister, which is another good one. And mind mapping tools are becoming more popular. A lot of people looking to applications like Whimsical that can connect with Notion just so that they can get the mind mapping abilities inside of their own application. So for companies, it's great for being able to plot out, say, a vision or a strategy, but for individuals, it's more suitable just for being able to coordinate some information and be able to maybe put a process to it, or even just to holistically view it from a 50,000 feet view. So if you're someone that uses, say, traditional to-do list application, note taker and all that, and that then wants a way to visually plan, then this could be a good way for you. It's a free application, so you're not losing anything out. And if you're a visual thinker, you've used Kanban boards all your life, then this might be a nifty tool and actually be a little bit more intuitive for you. So you can check out all about Miro mind mapping below. Thank you guys for stopping by. If you liked this video, hit the like button. And as you can imagine, become a subscriber if you're brand new. Comment below if you've already tried mind mapping tools out, or maybe you've tried Miro out. I'm sure the experience will help other people with their decision. But a big thank you for stopping by, and hopefully this was helpful. And I'll talk to you guys all very soon. Cheers, everyone. Bye.